One thing I don't leverage as often as I should, and that's pretty helpful, is the media management section of the site. So if I'm in my home and I go into this left side bar, I'm going to go into media, and you can see all the files that you've uploaded, all the different versions of those files. And it's even divided up into image and docs and videos and audio files. So if you're somebody who puts up video and you put up podcasts and you put up blog content, this is a really helpful way to manage assets that are in here. A cool thing you can do in here is actually edit some of these images and how they look. So if I wanted to go through and edit it here instead of while I'm creating my content, I can actually see all the attributes for it. So maybe I want to change its name. See, it has a reference and credit already built in because I pulled that from Openverse. I can add a description to it if I want, but I can also play around with the actual cropping. I could turn Yoda upside down if I wanted to, since he likes to hop around a lot. I can mirror image it, which is kind of neat. And I can also crop it down if I felt like that was too big. So I can apply some of the block level features to it, like the duotone filter or rounding it out or anything like that, but I can edit the photo. So if you find one you like, but you want to change the size of it, you want to change the orientation of it to make it fit the content that you're working on, you can actually do that from the media library, or say you wanted two different versions of one of them. Let's say I wanted, since for some reason I have two Chewbacca's in here. Oh, and you can multi-select and bulk edit too, which is kind of cool. So I'm going to choose this. I'm going to edit this image and say I want to flip this one. I'll click done and I'll save it. So now I have Chewbacca's facing two different ways in here, which is kind of neat. So you can see all the content in here. Like I said, if you have, you can filter it down to just images. I don't have any docs uploaded right now or any of these things, but if you have all those different assets, you can actually go in and see them and manage them. Maybe a document was an outdated version and you want to go in and replace it or edit it, get rid of the old one so you don't accidentally link it anywhere else and can link people to the new one. Maybe you have different versions of the videos or you want to clip and edit them down or something. So the media library is made to manage all these things. You can do a lot of this from the post editor when you're adding your image into it. But if you have a workflow where maybe you're uploading a bunch of images at the same time, or it's a series of images you might use across different pages and posts, the media library is a great place to upload them and get them set kind of the way that you want to, so you can go through and just make sure they're ready to go when you start putting your content in.